when he is out of sight, Gazar's birds can go caw-caw, and they fly through the air to a mountain top deep within the realm of the Titicus. Gazar finds a crystal cavern called Luminous Sunlight Cave, where, with his horse alone attending him, he meditates for 2 months. Gazar begins the final destruction of the Titicus. Gazar emanates 4 warriors identical to himself. From his body comes a warrior, carrying a standard marked with a tiger to stand at the Titicus Citadel's eastern gate. From his speech comes a warrior, standard is marked with a lion to stand at the northern gate. From his mind comes a warrior whose standard is marked with a Garuda at the western gate. And from his actions comes a warrior whose standard is marked with a dragon to take his stand at the southern gate. These warriors, the inseparable body, speech, mind, and action of the great Trala Lord Gazar of Ling, chant in unison. La-la-la, ha-la-la-la, do-la-la. Victim fathers, host of protectors and warriors, show your kindness, hear me now, be with me, bless me with your wishes. Today I will take the Titica fortress. I act only as your son. I call on you, O warrior fathers. Kikikila, ufa, kikikila. I call on the peaceful white lord of heaven's domain. Ki-li-li. Your helmet and armor are made of white crystal. Ride a horse the color of moonlight. On your right is a crystal arrow. On your left, a crystal bow. On your right, a long life arrow. On your left, a spear. On your right arm, a tiger's mane. On your left, a spotted leopard's skin. Your horse's tail swirls like a blizzard, and your brilliant white light pervades everywhere. Chow, chow, chow! Cut the Titicus connections to the heavenly realm. Let the winds of space descend and crush them to the ground. I call on the fearless golden lord of the earth's domain. Solilisa! You sit on a golden throne, wearing a helmet and armor of gold. Your arrow on the right and bow on the left are golden. On your right is a long life arrow, on your left a spear, on your right arm a tiger's mane, on your left a spotted leopard's skin. Smoke billows from the nostrils of your golden steed before you. Chow, chow, chow! Let the evil ones have no place on earth. Raise mountains up beneath them and breath them to the sky. I call on the inscrutable turquoise lord of the domains below earth and sea. Chalili! You sit on a turquoise throne, wearing turquoise helmet and armor. Your arrow, bow, long life arrow and spear are turquoise. On your right and left arms, you wear a tiger's mane and a leopard's skin. Your horse, blue as the rolling ocean, prances before you. Chow, chow, chow! And the flames from beneath earth and sea burn the earth corrupt so no ash remains. The Titicus in the fortress perceive this song not as melody and words, but as an unbearably sharp pain, as his sword points pierce their eardrums and press into the center of their brains. Then in turn, each of the warrior emanations begins to sing. First, at the eastern gate, the tiger warrior sings. At the eastern tower of the flaming tongues of hatred, thank you. northern gate the lion warrior sings. At the northern tower of the black wind of envy, oh, it's firm. Kindle the fire, still the pain. Gate the Garuda warrior sings at the western tower of blowing last. Oh, is firm, kindle the fire, steer the pain. The dragon warrior sings at the southern tower of the immense cavern of pride. Oh, it's firm, kindle the fire, seal the pain.
Set free, destroys all the Tyrtacus entirely. But their awareness, guided by the warrior songs of Gazar, recognizes its own liberation. And dissolves without hindrance into space. And the four emanations of warriors return to Gazar.